brought to you by the Cool Fat Burner, the world's first brown fat weight loss device.
Hey everyone, it's Eric with the Cool Fat Burner, and I'm here with what is probably the biggest, most important project yet. At long last, it is the long-awaited body recomposition experiment. Now before we go on, the first question that comes to mind is probably, what is body recomposition? Well, it comes from the root body composition. What is your body composed of? In other words, it's no longer good enough to just worry about burning fat. You must now worry about preserving or even building muscle. Did you know that when most regular people quote-unquote lose weight, that upwards of half of what they lose can be muscle loss? They're not even burning or losing fat, they're losing muscle. And this is inexcusable. It's bad because it leaves you more open to disorders and disease. You perform and look worse, you're not as healthy. It even lowers your resting metabolic rate. So you cannot lose muscle. Now the question that comes to mind is, well, how do you do that then? Well, this is where body recomposition, the body recomp plan, comes into play. How do you simultaneously burn calories, which requires a caloric deficit, yet also build new tissue, build muscle, which requires a caloric surplus? Well, with body recomp, the goal is to burn fat without losing muscle, or build muscle without gaining fat. Somehow you need to be able to do a surplus, or rather a deficit and a surplus at the same time. That's what body recomp is all about. Now the body recomp plan, too many details, would take too long to go over in this video. We'll have all the details in the site for CFB owners. The basic layout is this. You're going to have an anabolic growth day where you do resistance training. You're going to have carbs, and you can have your sweets and junk foods cheat meal on this day. This not only helps build and preserve muscle, but it also help maintain maximum leptin and thyroid levels, which keeps your metabolism running high, keeps cortisol and cravings low. At the other end, we'll have a targeted fat burning day. You're going to have hardcore CFB use, cold thermogenesis, and specific diet hacks to knock off huge amounts of fat. It'll also deplete glycogen that makes those incoming carbs go straight into muscles and not into fat. Then we'll have an adaptive day in between that can kind of go in either direction. That's the basic plan. Of course, we have clean bulk versions and targeting fat burning, focused metabolic variants of the body recomp plan. Now, one more thing, please keep in mind before we go on. This experiment ran like 9-10 months, okay? It started like last year this time, I was standing here, and it coincided with the first experiments I thought of, the resting metabolic rate and cold adaptation, the cool gut buster and spot reduction of stomach fat, and the big old cool fat burner activates brown fat as verified by PET scans. All three of those experiments, they were all running together last spring. Now to get befores and afters, I had to fatten up beforehand. I had to eat sweets, junk food, had to start drinking alcohol, and had to stop cool fat burner use to put it all on. With all that incoming calories, I thought, you know, why not try to channel some of this into muscle? So I started lifting real heavy, put on some old, I guess you say, old college muscle from back in the day. Then and only then did I have the idea to do this body recomp plan. Well, do you see the problem? I put on all this temporary deflating muscle that I was not going to keep unless I kept lifting big and eating big. And then and only then did I have the idea to try to do a body recomp plan where I'm probably going to be losing muscle regardless. Let's see what happened.
Okay, so let's check out those results. From the before to the after readings was exactly 8 weeks. I lost 14 pounds. 11 pounds of that was fat, taking me down from 22% to 18% body fat, which is roughly a 3-4-1 ratio. But I also lost 3 pounds of muscle. Now, as I mentioned before, that makes me wonder, well, what if I hadn't done that pre-bulk before the experiment? So last year, I was walking around 184, 85 pounds. After the pre-bulk, I was 209 pounds. I put on 10 pounds of muscle, all verified by DEXA scan. What if I hadn't put on that 10 pounds of muscle before this experiment? I was able to keep 7 of the 10 pounds. I only lost 3. What if I hadn't pre-bulked? Would I instead gained 7 pounds during that time? Kind of hard to say. Maybe not, but definitely food for thought. More important is the fat loss numbers. Let's take a look at those real quick. Keep in mind, with the body recomp plan, I'm only burning fat, like on the basic plan, I'm only burning fat one out of every 3 days. So in a 6 day week, 6 day cycle, that's only two of those 6 days I'm burning fat. The other 2 days are for building muscle, the other 2 days are preserving, maintaining muscle, then the other two for burning fat. Well, do the math. I lost 11 pounds of fat in 8 weeks. That's over a pound of fat a week. That's over a pound of fat in 2 days per week, roughly. So that means I was burning around 2,500 calories a day each of those fat burning days. And you might say, well, is that, you know, how are you burning all those calories? Well, with cold thermogenesis, cool fat burner was the prime mover during the first leg of this experiment. Remember, it was that record-breaking winter, so I could do cool fat burner, you know, hardcore intensity, maybe even go full all-out shivering for maybe an hour or so, sit in a really cold room, 55-degree room for an hour or two after that. And this coincided with the resting metabolic rate, the gut buster, all those other experiments. So as I mentioned in those videos, you know, I'm doing 6-8 hour sessions almost daily, sometimes up to 10 or 12 hour sessions. Now we know from the indirect calorimetry experiment, you know, I'm burning, you know, triple calorie burn when I'm shivering. So even if I just go to shivering several times throughout the day and then coast off that, because we know from the PET scan experiments that my brown fat stays active long after I take the vest off. It would be active all day, actually. We know from the resting metabolic rate that my metabolism is super high, between 30 and sometimes up to 60%, just walking around, even without wearing the vest. So I'm burning massive amounts of calories and fat on those days. Then if you were to add just the smallest little bit of dietary protocols, fasting, protein-sparing, modified fast, low-carb, whatever, it'd be easy to knock off half a pound of fat in a day. Easy. And finally, one other kind of interesting tidbit here is about ketosis. I'd mentioned in the past about how using a cool fat burner allows me to enter ketosis faster if I'm on a low carb diet and want to, you know, experiment with a ketogenic diet. During this experiment and using the body recomp plan, notice how it works. On the third day, I'm doing these long hours of cold thermogenesis, having no carbs. By the time I come around to day one again, I was entering ketosis, and there were several days where, even after having a little bit of carbs in my post-workout meal, I would still be in ketosis. I would drop from more intense ketosis down to a more mild version, but I'd still be in ketosis. What that means is I'm depleting muscle glycogen. Almost all of it, well, I'm working out day one and two. I am having a big refeed on day one, but on day three, all the cold thermogenesis and no carbs, I'm pretty much depleting my glycogen in that one day. And then when it comes to day one, I can have that huge post-workout meal, and all of those carbs are going to go to refill glycogen and not to, you know, affect fat storage in any way. So the first part of the experiment was a huge success. We burned over half a pound of fat, around 2,500 calories in a single day. And those interested in low-carb diets and ketosis, this cold exposure, cold thermogenesis, cool fat burner definitely made entering and maintaining ketosis a lot quicker and easier.
Okay, so I lost a heck of a lot of fat. However, arguably, depending on how you interpret it, I also did lose some muscle. I either would have gained 6 or 7 pounds of muscle, or arguably lost around 3 pounds of muscle. That's still a ratio of like 3:4:1, which is actually the ideal ratio that most, you know, regular plans aim for. 3 pounds or three or four fat to 1 pound of muscle. Still, I knew I could have done better. I knew that the temporary muscle bulk in the beginning screwed over the results, so I wanted to go and prove that I could build muscle and burn fat at the same time. So then we switched to the clean bulk variant of the body recomp plan. Let's see what happened.
Okay, so for the clean bulk version leg of this experiment, I took a few weeks off after the first leg fat burning, and then into the clean bulk, which went from April 10th to May 12th, almost 4 weeks exactly. My total weight went up to 196.5 pounds. My lean muscle went up to 156.4. That's an increase of 2.1 pounds of muscle. And my fat went down to 32 pounds. That's 16.8% body fat. So I lost 1.7 pounds of fat. So right there was body recomp accomplished. Gained 2 pounds of muscle, lost 1.7 pounds of fat. Now, right away, a person would say, well, how is this possible? How are you doing this? How are you simultaneously gaining muscle and losing fat? Remember our experiments we've already done, adiponectin, irisin. We've shown that cool thermogenesis, cool fat burner, can directly and indirectly help maintain and build muscle tissue. Adiponectin increases mitochondrial biogenesis in your skeletal muscle. Irisin helps lower myostatin. Kind of an interesting factoid. If you've ever seen those ultra-muscled animals, dogs and bulls and so forth, they had genetically lowered myostatin. That's something in the bodybuilding community, they're trying so hard to find something that lowers myostatin. Well, the cool fat burners, we'll see upcoming experiments and videos, it does increase irisin. Irisin lowers myostatin. Lower myostatin allows more muscle to be built. So right there are several direct means by which cool thermogenesis can help build muscle. And of course, there are indirect methods, helping sleep at night, sleep enhancement, post-workout recovery, even nutrient partitioning. That's a big one here. That's something that no one else has really used cool thermogenesis to directly build muscles via insulin sensitivity, depleting glycogen, nutrient partitioning, and then glycogen supercompensation, all to increase protein synthesis in conjunction with heavy working out. And here's a neat little anecdote. Here's me at an ice cream festival where I had, amongst a whole bunch of other food, 18 dips of ice cream. Afterwards, my blood sugar did not go up that high at all because I'm highly insulin sensitive. When I eat, my muscles and brown fat use the nutrients. It doesn't float around in my system. It doesn't get stored as fat. It doesn't cause systemic inflammation. Refills muscle glycogen. I still threw in a cool fat burner later that evening, and afterwards you see my blood sugar is even lower yet. More of it taken up into the tissues, into muscle, into brown adipose tissue. The next day, my waistline hadn't budged an inch. Muscles were even more pumped. So that's the clean bulk version right there. Deplete glycogen with cold thermogenesis, have a good strong resistance training workout, eat plenty of sweets and carbs, even junk food if you want. Use the cool fat burner again to help further push it into your muscles. Next day, reap the rewards.
Okay, so the clean bulk variant was a success. It proved that body recomp is possible. Gained almost 2 pounds of muscle, which is a lot for someone at my age and training experience, and while losing almost 2 pounds of fat. Gained 2 pounds of muscle, lost almost 2 pounds of fat. That's awesome. I argue it probably would have happened during the first leg of the experiment as well, but whatever. It is what it is. But here's the thing. I was experiencing so much improvement, almost week by week, seeing change, I thought, you know what? Let's push this further and take it in the opposite extreme. Let's switch to the targeted, focused metabolic variant of the body recomp plan. Let's focus completely on burning fat while maintaining as much muscle as possible. Check out the results.
Okay, so in the metabolic variant of the plan, there's a lot of high-intensity work, anaerobic power endurance. There's some low-intensity, steady-state cardio, and you do hardcore cool fat burner use just about every day of the week, except maybe the anabolic day. On the metabolic plan, I was making great progress. I was dropping weight, seeing changes week by week, but a whole lot of old injuries from decades past started to pop up, and I really wasn't able to work out that much. I'll bet I missed at least a third of my workouts, and doing resistance training and working out is a large part of what lets you keep muscle during a cut. So on August 12th, went and got the final DEXA scan. I was down to 185 pounds. I had 155 pounds of muscle and 21.4 pounds of fat. I was down to 8-9% body fat by skin calipers, 12% DEXA. So I lost 10 pounds of fat and only 1 pound of muscle. That's a ratio of 10-1. I lost roughly close to 1 pound a week. Me getting 10-1, I was pretty darn happy. So there you have it. The metabolic variant, lose lots of fat, preserve pretty much all your muscle.
Okay, so there we have it. We see that the body recomp plan, cool fat burner, in conjunction with particular diet and exercise, the body recomp plan, it works. It can let you lose massive amounts of fat, gain significant amounts of muscle, and let you do it at the same time. But I already know what probably some people out there are thinking. They're saying, okay, sure, you got good results there, but what about all these carbs and sweets and junk food you're eating? Surely that would wreak havoc on your health and your systems. Well, see, there's something I haven't mentioned yet. Through this whole process, I did a complete array of blood tests, monitored health markers, even did DNA testing. Let's see what happened there.
every time I would do these various experiments and I would fatten up beforehand, usually over winter, I would often get blood work. And of course, all my numbers would start to look really bad, even after only one or two, well, a few months of fattening up. That's because I have a, probably in part because I have a family history of obesity and heart disease and so on. So things like triglycerides and my, you know, cholesterol numbers, my pre-diabetic numbers, all of those things would start looking pretty bad every winter when I would do these experiments. So how did they turn out with this experiment? My cholesterol numbers were great, including my very low density particles. My diabetic numbers, the stuff that supposedly might help lead to inflammation, certain types of cancer, all of these numbers were great. Even my resting insulin was low, almost implying that I'm in constant fat burning mode. I even went so far as to get my DNA tested out of curiosity, and it was up to the 86th percentile. Or interestingly, irisin, which the cool fat burner can increase, irisin can lengthen DNA telomeres. Now, in a perfect world, I would have gotten my DNA tested every year or so for the last couple years, but this stuff is so new I wasn't able to, so take that with a grain of salt. So there you go. Blood markers look great despite eating carbs and sweets and junk, whatever. No inflammation, no pre-diabetes, no heart disease, no bad numbers anywhere.
In celebration of the great results, on September 13th, I went to a local ice cream festival and brought home 64 pounds of homemade ice cream. That's pounds, not scoops. And over the next month, in continued celebration, I pulled back on the body recomp plan, pulled back on everything. Cool fat burner, dieting, working out, went kind of on maintenance mode. And during that month, I had lots of buffet food and ice cream and more buffet food. Restaurant food, bar food, and buffet food on top of that. On October 19th, I finished the 64 pounds of ice cream. Here's a picture of me, waistline up maybe an inch. A few days later, the first shiver walk, still got abs, even though I was 20 pounds heavier. Where did it all go? Cold thermogenesis, glycogen depletion, nutrient partition, glycogen supercompensation, protein synthesis, all went to the muscles. All my lifts, explosiveness, power, strength, hypertrophy, all the way through endurance, everything went up. Cool fat burner, cold thermogenesis, body recomp plan. It works. Until next time.